Hello everyone, welcome to MindBrain Talks, the place where you find diverse and scientifically accurate information regarding psychology, psychotherapy, neuropsychology and neurosciences every single week. My name is Bruno Faustino, I am a licensed clinical psychologist and neuropsychologist who's been working as a therapist, researcher and educator for the past few years. Here, I discuss and describe lots of topics, research findings and methods regarding psychology and neuroscience for you to understand it and for you to learn something about it. All videos here are just for educational purposes and it's not intended to diagnose any psychiatric condition or neurological disorder. So, without further delay, let's jump for today's content. So, today I will talk about a statistical test called one-way ANOVA, okay? And I'll show to you how to perform it in the SPSS, but first I'll give you some notions about the ANOVA and I'll give you some information for you to understand how this test works and how you may utilize it in your statistical problems, okay? Let's go! I've used these four manuals to prepare myself to develop this video, and I think these four manuals are very good in explaining how we can use statistics and how we can apply statistics to every kind of psychological problem and how we can perform these tests in SPSS. So if you like what you're seeing here, please check the video description and you will find there these four manuals. One-way ANOVA, called the analysis of the variance, compares the two means of two or more independent groups and tries to explore the statistical differences between these means. The difference between the one sample t-test is that here we can compare more than two groups, okay? Also, it's a parametric test. And one-way ANOVA allows to contrast in the post-hoc comparisons to see which specific pairs of means are significantly different within different samples or groups, okay? We can test more than two groups and then we can compare specifically which differences are between each means of different groups. We can pair specific groups to see if there is statistical differences between means, okay? So, if we have three groups, for instance, we can compare these three groups, okay? So now, let's look to the parametric assumptions of one-way ANOVA. The dependent variable must be continuous and independent variable must be categorical. We need a random sample from data population. And we need a normal distribution. Also, we expect to have homogeneity of the variances and we expect not to have outliers in our sample. Now let's look to our hypothetical research problem. So, let's see. Individuals in clinical groups and waiting lists tend to show higher symptomatology than individuals in non-clinical groups. However, this assumption must be explored. Now we can infer some operant condition, such as individuals in clinical sample and waiting list show higher psychological symptoms than individuals in non-clinical sample. Our H0, our null hypothesis, is that there is any difference between these means, and our H1 hypothesis is that we should find a difference between these three groups, a difference between the means in these three groups. Okay, so now let's go to SPSS. So now we are here in the SPSS environment, and as you can see, we have our sample, okay, our variable related to the sample. We have two, sample two, sample 1, okay, and sample 3, okay? So now, and we have here the other variable regarding our hypothesis, which is symptomatology, okay? And then I'll show to you how to perform a one-way ANOVA, okay? So, you just go here, analyze, compare means, then we move to one way nova, okay, right there, select, and select a nova and shows this table. Now we will select symptomatology and our sample. So as you can see, we have this menu regarding contrasts, but we will not choose nothing, okay? But we will choose here the Bofaroni corrections to see the post hoc comparison, okay? As I said before, this comparison allows us to understand the differences, the specific differences between the three means of the three different groups, okay? So, okay. Here we will not choose nothing, okay? Because this video, it's only about ANOVA, okay? And let's just press okay. So we have these two tables. As you can see, the comparison between groups, okay? Here we have the sum of squares, degrees of freedom, the mean squares, the F, the value for ANOVA, and our significance, okay? As you can see, our p-value is below 0.5, therefore there is a significant difference between the three means of these groups. And now we can see here the multiple comparisons. As you can see, we have the non-clinical compared to the clinical sample and the waiting list. As you can see, they are all significant differences. Here we have the clinical sample comparing the mean with the non-clinical sample and the waiting list. As you can see, the non-clinical difference between clinical sample and non-clinical sample is different, okay? Statistically different. But from the clinical sample from waiting list, there is not a significant difference between these two means. As you can see, the p-value is higher than 0.05, okay? And here we can see that the waiting list mean, it's different between the non-clinical, okay? Because it's below 0.05, but, and it's the same result here and here, it's not significant for the clinical group. So this means that the individuals in the waiting list and in clinical sample do not have different values on symptomatology, okay? But when compared to the non-clinical sample, as you can see, there is a significant difference between these two means, which means that individuals in a non-clinical sample have a value in symptomatology, and individuals on the waiting list and on clinical samples do not have a difference between these two means, okay? So, I hope that you enjoyed the contents of today, and don't forget to see the video description regarding today's theme to look to the references that I think that are very useful to understand these concepts. Also, if you like what I'm doing here, please consider to subscribe and hit the bell button for notifications. If you want to say something about these topics, please use the comment section below to express your mind. Welcome to the Mind Brain Talks, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!